As you can see, we have some porcelain down there. Right, guys, I think it's loose finally. One, two, three.
Yeah. Oh! Lucky bastard.
I'd like to take a short moment to express my gratitude to Skillshare for sponsoring today's video. For those of you that have never heard of it, Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of inspiring classes for creators. Explore new skills, deepen exciting passions, and get lost in creativity. Whatever your awesome hobby or occupation is, if you want to become creative with it like me, there are many classes that will help you with this process. Class topics about video editing, photoshopping, and website design really helped me to grow my experience. Advanced Video Editing with Adobe Premiere Pro 2020 by Jordi van der Put is my favorite. No more technical challenges after this class, but more time to focus on the creative side of editing. Skillshare focuses on learning, meaning there are no ads and premium classes are always being launched. Therefore, you can stay focused and follow wherever your passion guides you. All of this is possible through an annual subscription of less than $10 a month. The first 1,000 of my subscribers to click the link in the description will get a free trial of premium membership so you can explore your creativity. I just arrived at my buddy Ray. I'm gonna pick him up and we're gonna drive together to Germany where we're gonna meet some other friends. Hey. Rob just found a blown up shell casing, a brass one.
It's 1942.
Yeah, that's the fine work of a copper brush. You can get all of those nice details back. Right there is where Rob just found that blown up shell casing. Right next to it, I got a very high 90 signal on my dais. And yeah, you can see it over here. I think I scratched it here a little bit. I can see an original gold brass color. Yeah, and it's another one. So now I also have a nice ashtray. Really happy with that. Let's see if we can maybe reveal some of those details. We're probably gonna be needing a copper brush for this one, but let's get that dirt off. Yeah, there's some clear markings there. Is there a year already visible? There, 1942, guys. It's right there. My buddy Rob from World War II Unknown just did a quick Google search and found out that these shell casings are fired by the American M5 cannon. The US 3-inch M5 was an anti-tank gun that saw limited use due to its heavy weight and ammunition-related issues. For this reason, it was gradually removed from frontline services in 1945. And yeah, obviously, I don't have to explain that these shell casings normally were not blown up, so probably they had some fire pit here, or maybe some ammunition accidentally went off and this thing got blown to bits. I'm not sure, but yeah, really happy we're finding these. There's a lot of foxholes in this area. See one right here, and Ray is digging over there in the back, also in the foxhole. Let's see what he's got right there. As you can see, these guys are working hard on a dump pit that they just found. This is what came out already. So we have some bottles, some tubes, some porcelain, and they even found a... Well, I think this is a pencil, a part of it at least, the carbon. So that's quite cool. I mean, I think we're not done here for a while. Well, we just got our confirmation. Bob just pulled out a piece of porcelain which clearly has an eagle on it and a part of a German swastika. This is actually Luftwaffe porcelain, so that's the German Air Force. It's not complete, unfortunately, but you know, this is the first piece which is marked, and there's much more in there.
The Luftwaffe was formally created in 1935, but military aviation existed in Germany since the end of World War I. This department of the Wehrmacht consisted of pilots, paratroopers and ground support. The Luftwaffe played a key role in operations like the Battle of Britain and the Battle of Creed. Many paratrooper formations were actually used as light infantry in all theaters of war. The Reichsarbeitsdienst also provided ground personnel for the Luftwaffe, mainly for airfield construction and anti-aircraft purposes. Next interesting item to come out is right over there. We think it's a knife, or at least it once was a knife. This is the handle, and the blade is broken off. Still some wood left here even. Yeah, cool one. I don't think that this is a standard issue knife or anything, but that's a cool piece. Alright, Bob just pulled out this complete German battery pack, and I have seen complete battery packs before, but never like this. Look at this condition, guys. 40, 60, 80, there's original German writing here. What does it say? Belüftungsschlitze, Achtung, warning. That means you can see all of the batteries still here. Wow, man, how is this paper still intact? That's crazy. Those guys in the back are still working on the dump pit. And I'm just detecting the area around it a little bit. And I just found my first coin of the day. You can see it right over here. I think it's a German 10 Pfennig from what I saw already. Yeah, you can see the 10 over there. All right, Bob just found another piece of porcelain, and it's apparently it's so nice that he's coming over to show me. Oh man, are you kidding me? That's a complete one. Yeah, that's what I was talking about, the Luftwaffe stamp and complete one. I mean, congrats on that one. Just discovered something made from Bakelite. I found this before in a previous video. It's cool to see this again. I think it's called a Zunderbusche. This is the cap, and it would have been a Bakelite container below this. These containers were used to hold 88 millimeter artillery fuses. And there should be something on the inside. I think I can see a year there on the right. There it says 1938. So yeah, keep your eyes peeled, guys. This is all non-metal, and we don't want to miss out on anything. Well, we've definitely hit the right time frame. This piece here says 1943, Rosenthal Bahnhof Zelb. This here is some typical German toothpaste, Blendax. I showed that before in a previous video. We often find this brand. It's quite a common one. It's cool to see it again here at a brand new location. And there's yet another one. Very nice Luftwaffe stamp. And look at this, guys. We got a complete plate here. All the pieces fit together. It's quite special. I think I just found a wallet, piece of leather with some sort of, well, there was a buckle here. I'm questioning if there's going to be coins in there, but let's see if we can open this. And there we go. Is there something inside? Yeah, sorry guys, no coins in there, but it is a World War II wallet, so that's a really cool find. Let's close it up for now. Still good for display though. Well, the hole is getting bigger and bigger, and we just discovered a German matchbox, and there's something on there. We think
it's a German helmet.
German helmet. There should be a German soldier on there. There. You can see the side of a face over here. So this would have been folded shut, matchbox. As you can see, we have some porcelain down there. So let's see if we can excavate that carefully. Right guys, I think it's loose finally. I'm quite sure that this stamp is going to be complete on this one, guys. One, two, three.
Oh! Lucky bastard. And he's impressed.
Yeah, there's another piece. It's the second one. Look at this, guys. It's almost complete. Luftwaffe plate. Let's get the next one out. There we go. You guys ready?
Really?
Yes.
Really happy with that. Never found so many complete ones in one hole. It's a great exploration we're doing here. Good day. Again, a very classic story of how a very small excavation turns very big. Let me just give you a close-up of everything that came out. A lot of porcelain pieces, a lot of small bottles as well, both liquor, perfume bottles. Yeah, and here are also some goodies. All this Luftwaffe porcelain. It's all very clearly marked still. I decided to help out, you know, by now we're all fitting in here, so I was digging here and all of a sudden I spot something roundish, so I'm looking at this and I don't know if you recognize it, but this is the front part of a Luftwaffe belt buckle, I believe, made from aluminum. You can already see the swastika down there, but we're looking at the wrong side right now, so we have to brush it up and yeah, let's have a look. There is some, is that just dirt or corrosion? The backside is still very pretty, so must be still good on this side. The belt buckle, maybe it's still in there. This is just the front piece. Oh, Jesus, that's the first one for me, I have to say. I found some iron belt buckles, never the aluminum ones. I still haven't because this is just a piece of it, but still. It's almost like finding a badge, I mean. Mm-hmm. I mean, it looks like a badge in there, like this. The other parts, we're gonna clean that later on, but you can already see the eagle. German Luftwaffe eagle, part of a German Luftwaffe belt buckle. Very pretty. Nice one.
Yeah.
Okay. At quite some points here, we've already reached the edge of this dump site, so I'm not sure how much more we're gonna find, but at least there is a very consolidated layer here. And I just excavated this tube. And it's a German chlorodont tube, toothpaste tube. But this one is in a quite nice condition still. You can read almost everything on it, so I'm definitely putting that one to the side. As you can see, we've excavated this whole freaking thing and almost all of the signals are gone. And Ray pointed out that he was going to use his detector to see if there was something in the sand that we already excavated. And he had a very, very loud signal. And look what he just pulled out. This is an aluminum German belt buckle. And the funny thing is, the front piece here is missing. And earlier on in this video, we found the front piece of a Luftwaffe belt buckle, also an aluminum piece. So we can actually be quite sure that that belongs on this part here. That is a very nice one. All right, just to show you for size comparison. It's gotta be at least 2 by 2 meters. But don't worry, we're gonna close it up in a second. Almost done, as you can see. Man, that's a lot of work. We did move locations just now, and Ray found the first interesting item over here, World War II related, that is. You can see it right over there. I'm not gonna touch it, but yeah, Ray just shouted and said that he thought that he found a hand grenade. And I think that he is right. That looks like a British Mills hand grenade. I am very sure about that. And yeah, this one has not gone off. They definitely did try to fire this one. So like I said, I'm not gonna touch it further. We're gonna mark the location, bury it, and call the bomb squad, and they will make sure that this is disposed of in a careful way. The British hand grenade is frequently referred to as the Mills bomb. They were the first modern fragmentation grenades used by the British Army. It was designed in 1915 and has seen action in both world wars. The Mills has a classic pineapple design, which is very similar to the US MK2 grenade. Bob's detector is over there and he just came walking towards me and he showed me that he found a part of a razor. Believe it or not, but my signal right next to this, it's actually a complete razor. See it over here? It's quite shiny still. It's probably stainless steel. Jesus, that's a complete, it's a complete one, man. Somebody want to help me with a brush? Let's see if you can clean it up a little bit. It doesn't need that much cleaning, it's mostly just dirt. It's definitely a stainless steel one. I never actually saw this particular type before. Have any of you?
No, it's a beauty.
And there's probably a brand in there, a year or a manufacturer stamp. Must be. Nice, that looks really pretty.
Well, the markings are clear as day. This razor was made in America and is of great quality as it still functions.
I had a lot of fun today with World War II Unknown, the Dutch Relic Diggers, and Market Garden Battlefields. Go check out their channels. We're gonna go home now. Special thank you to my patrons. Your names will appear somewhere on the screen right now. You help us to keep creating this content as we love to do. See you guys next video.